Hello friends, under alteration of memorandum of association under company law 2013, we have earlier done how to do the changes in the name clause, how to change the registered office from one place to another place within the same city, and secondly we did how to change from one city to another state but within the same state. Then we did how to change from one state to another state. In this lecture, we will do how to make changes in the objective clause, how to make changes in the capital clause, liability clause, subscription clause. In case of one person company, how to change the nominee clause. First of all, we are going to do how to make changes in the objective clause. And in the 2013 Act, the alteration of objective clause does not require to be specified purpose which were given in earlier section 17. They have been omitted in as per the new Act. The board meeting has to be convened to get the approval of the directors for changing the object clause. And then they will decide at which date the extraordinary general meeting has to be called. Extraordinary general meeting should be convened. Notice of the meeting along with explanatory statement should be given 21 clear days notice to the members, directors as well as the auditors. Here the special resolution has to be passed by means of postal ballot, and 3/4 majority is required. 75% voting should be in favor of the passing changing of the objective clause. And secondly, we have to get the approval of the shareholder by passing a special resolution. Second, we have to get the approval of Ministry of Corporate Affairs, and there we have to pass a special resolution to the registrar of company using form MGT 14 within 30 days, and we have to submit some documents along with that form, requisite fee, notice related to the extraordinary general meeting, certified true copy of the special resolution, altered memorandum of association, and copy of the board resolution, which is not obligatory but which could also be filed. In case it is a public limited company, details of the special resolution has to be published one English newspaper, and the second is the regional language having circulation where the registered office of the company is situated. And the dissenting shareholder must be provided an opportunity to exit via the promoters and shareholders. It means promoter can buy the shares of the dissenting shareholders, or it could be purchased by the shareholder which agree to the change in the objective clause. Then there is a change in the capital clause. Section 61 deals with the alteration of share capital. Section 60 deals with the increase in share capital. In case the company is increasing in authorized share capital, they have to follow the procedure which is given under section 61, 64 along with the rule 15 of the company's share capital and debentures rules. Then they have to check the provision of article of association. Article of association permit change in authorized share capital. If article of association is silent, then it has to be amended as per the Company Act. The section 17-14 is applicable. It can be amended by passing a special resolution in extraordinary general meeting, and form MGT 14 is required to be filed for changing in the alteration of articles. Then notice of calling board meeting should be given to 7 days before, and on the appointed day the board meeting is called and the approval of the director is obtained, and then the extraordinary general meeting is called. Here the notice is issued along with the explanatory statement, 21 days clear notice, and extraordinary general meeting is held, and here the resolution to increase share capital is passed. and the information has to be filed in the form SH7 along with the notice of the extraordinary general meeting, ordinary resolution and the altered copy of memorandum of association along with the difference in the fees, and also if stamp duty is applicable, then the difference in the stamp duty is also applicable, that has to be also paid along with the changed a memorandum of association. Section 62, a company which is having share capital may alter its capital clause subject to the provision of article. If article of association permit, if they don't permit, that could be amended by passing a resolution in the extraordinary general meeting. The confirmation of the court is not required if the following situation: if the company wants to increase its share capital, if the company wants to consolidate and divide its capital into share of larger amount, to convert its fully paid share into stock or stock into shares, to subdivide its shares and shares of smaller amount, to cancel its shares. A change in the description of the share from rupees 100 to rupees 10 or to rupees 10 to 100 or vice versa does not require any formality. But in case of reduction of share capital, special resolution is required. When section 62 deals with these kinds of changes, then they have to pass the ordinary resolution. Within 30 days notice to the registrar of company for the consolidation, dividing, for the decision which is taken to cancel or redemption, that has to be given, and default will render company and every officer of the company liable to pay fine up to rupees 1000 per day, or it may extend to rupees 5 lakh. Then there is a change in the liability clause. Without the written consent of a member, his liability cannot be increased. A limited company, if authorized by article of association, by passing a special resolution, may alter memorandum of association to make the liability of manager or director unlimited, and the concerned person, and before making their liability unlimited, the company has to get the consent of the concerned person. If they don't give the consent, the limited company cannot make their liability unlimited. If the company is a club or any other similar association, alteration of memorandum of association required the member to pay recurring or periodical subscription or changes at high rate, although they don't agree, but they have to be bound by the alteration. And there is no provision to change in the subscription clause. In case of one person company, the nominee clause can be changed as per rule sub rule 5 of the rule 4 of the company's incorporation rules by informing the one person company at any time. The sole member can change the nominee. They have to get the consent of the new nominee in the form INC3. They have to file with the registrar of company within 30 days. Change in the form INC with the consent in form INC of the new nominee and along with the prescribed fees.